being presented to you by Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, in association with La Cerveza Tecate con Carácter. This bout, a 12-round WBC Super Welterweight World Title Eliminator. Supervising for the WBC, Craig Hubbell. The judges at ringside are Dave Moretti, Ricardo Ocasio, and Jerry Roth. The referee, Jay Nady. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the fight capital of the world, we find out, ¿quién es el más macho? Introducing first, the fighter in the blue corner. He enters the ring wearing red, white, green, and gold. When he stepped on the scale, he weighed in at an official 153.5 pounds. And in 19 professional bouts, he maintains a record of 17 victories against one lone defeat, one draw, and 11 of his victories coming by way of knockout. The two-time world amateur champion, and now the number one ranked super welterweight contender, de Guantanamo, Cuba, Erislandy, El Oro de Guantanamo, Lara. Standing across the ring in the red corner, wearing blue with silver trim, when he stepped on the scale, he weighed in at an official 153 pounds. As an amateur, he proudly represented the USA in the 2004 Olympics. And after entering the ring 32 times as a professional, he maintains an undefeated record of 32 victories. 20 of those victories coming by way of knockout. The number two ranked contender in the super welterweight division, representing Abovian, Armenia, Banes, the Nightmare Martirosyan.
Twelve rounds. Obey my commands. Good luck. Buena suerte. Touch gloves. Go to work.
Vanes Martirosyan wants to get it going here in his career. He's 32-0, but he has not yet faced the top of the division. Erislandy Lara wants to keep it going here. He's fared very well against the best 154-pounders in the world.
And Martirosyan told us, my Armenian fans, they support me, but even they say, step it up, Vanes. Well, he's in tough tonight against Lara. Talked about Lara and his son in Cuba celebrating a birthday. We need to send our congratulations to Vanes and his wife, Gabby. A week ago, they welcomed their daughter, Ariana, to the world to go along with son, Andrew. So Vanes said that, listen, the baby came early. Training camp has gone well. There's been no injuries. Everything has been perfect. I'm more focused now than I've ever been. We'll see if it pays off in the ring against Lara. Martirosyan's been on the deck three times in his career. Lara's never been down. Roy, what about the fact that Lara's trainer is Ronnie Shields, who for a while worked with Martirosyan? Ronnie felt that Martirosyan really hasn't changed from when he worked with him. Is that an advantage for Lara?
Well, I think it's an advantage because now his corner knows Martirosyan better than Martirosyan's corner knows Lara. However, I think that also will encourage Martirosyan to come in and prove that he's gotten better. So we'll have to see. But right away, the only thing I don't like about Martirosyan is how close he has his hands to his head.
These guys are already exchanging a little bit more maybe than some would have anticipated this early in the fight.
They're both coming out to impress, and they're both trying to win this fight. They're throwing big punches, Lara throwing a good straight left hand to Martirosyan's body. As you see, Martirosyan's body is really red already from the left hand. And Martirosyan throwing some big shots to Lara's head, trying to get that respect.
Interesting, because both guys said of the other guy, if you hit him, they're going to want to run.
Well, Martirosyan didn't say that Lara was going to want to run. He said Lara wouldn't take the punch well. Lara said Martirosyan's going to run, and so did Shields.
Now, right hand by Lara. Snap back the head of Martirosyan. There's that long left to the body by Lara.
What he'll do is continually try to throw that shot, and he'll try to eventually change it to overhand left and catch Martirosyan looking for the body shot.
End of round one.
Okay, very good round, very good rounds. Everything is good. Yeah, everything is good. Look, keep using the jab. Just stay busy. Just stay busy with the left, with the jab hand, because he's scoring with the jab. Okay, on these rounds, you know, look, it's a good round for him. Okay, keep going to the body like.
From the outside, knee right in hook. Okay, all right. You just need to get a little closer with the fingers. All right, you do the thing, the thing, the thing, drop the right hand hook on him right away. Okay, all right.
We're in the copy box. Martirosyan landed three punches in the round out of 22. Those three connects with power shots. Lara landed 6 of 9 power shots, 11 in total of his 36 punches thrown.
Both were really good amateurs. Lara with more success on the international stage, but when you have national success in this country, it means you're facing the likes of Tim Bradley when Martirosyan was an amateur, Austin Trout, Andre Berto, and he has wins against all those guys in the amateurs, Martirosyan does.
Yeah, he has a very good amateur pedigree, especially for this country. But the only thing that's in the back of his mind is that he's 0-3 against the Cubans. So he wants to come out and change that tonight. And as a professional, he gets more rounds to try to change it.
And in the run-up between Athens and Beijing, the name Lara, as the 2005 world champion, was one of the people that was being talked about as part of the Cuban team that was going to go to Beijing and potentially win the gold medal. And then he defected.
That body shot right there is going to be a very effective punch all night long for Lara.
Martirosyan jumped in. Lara blocked a lot of it.
I think Martirosyan wants to take this fight to the distance because he feels the further down the line it goes, the better he shall fare.
Stop! Wait!
Like an accidental clash of heads there. Martirosyan paused at the left eye. He's been cut 3 times in his career. All 3 times it's been the left eye.
I tell you what, they're both throwing some really big punches in this fight early.
But as you mentioned, Roy, Lara's having real success with that straight left hand to the body and or body shots, period. And if Martirosyan thinks he's going to wear Lara down physically as this fight wears on, that doesn't bode well for him taking those body shots.
Well, it doesn't, but right now, as you see, Lara has gotten a little bit afraid of Martirosyan's power, and he's starting to back up a lot more than we saw him backing up earlier. Earlier, he was willing to stand in there and take a gamble and try to land a shot. Now he's grabbing and he gets close, or he's getting out of there. So.
No more. Box.
Martirosyan definitely has got his respects on.
Martirosyan insists that he's the kind of fighter who will fight up or down to the level of opposition, and that the reason he hasn't yet looked spectacular in his pro career is because he hasn't faced this kind of challenge.
Well, he has it right now.
Work our way to the end of round number two. This shot scheduled for 12 rounds. And there is the wife of Erislandy Lara, Yudi, watching anxiously here at ringside in Las Vegas. Well, Mikey Garcia stopped Jonathan Barros with a left hand in the eighth round, and Roy being attended to by his people. Obviously, you go into it with tremendous high hopes. Let's talk about sort of the emotion that the fighter feels after being defeated as he was starting to work his way into the fight.
It's kind of difficult, man. I mean, nobody likes to lose. No fighter does. And that's why boxing is one of the oldest sports, but yet one of the most real-life sports, because nobody wants to lose in anything, even in life. So boxing is one of these sports, though, that teaches you right away that when you get knocked down or when you lose, you must get back up and resettle and ride even harder.
Barros, a former world champion who made two title defenses, suffers the fourth loss of his professional career. We begin round number three of this scheduled 12-round bout. Erislandy Lara and Vanas Martirosyan.
And I think this fight is about to get a little bit more interesting, because this round, somebody should land a good headshot against somebody. I don't know who yet, but somebody should land something big this round.
Why, just because you see them getting closer to each other?
Yeah, they're getting closer, and they're getting more anxious, and they know each other now. You see how Erislandy came at him just then? Oh! See what I'm saying? They both starting to get a little bit more anxious.
Don't do that again.
So,
in other words, a fight's about to break out.
That's exactly right.
Well, we showed you earlier at the weigh-in, they got in each other's grill, and Lara actually shoved Martirosyan. Well, that sort of intensity is now definitely carried into the ring.
Yeah, good right upshot by Lara just now, too. He threw a left-hand lead followed by a good right upper jab.
Short counter right from Lara. Moves away from the attack of Martirosyan. Good left hand by Lara.
There's definitely more mustard on these shots this round so far.
That's what I was trying to tell you. Oh, good hook.
Good hook!
By the arms of Lara.
Yeah, Martirosyan should go more to Lara's body, because, you know, Lara is definitely comfortable moving around, but when he's attacked, he throws both of his hands up pretty high. So Martirosyan has to take advantage of that and do like Lara has been doing to him and go to his body very hard.
And Lara's using his shoulders well to avoid their shots upstairs. Turning and catching those shots on his upper arms and shoulders.
Which is another reason that Martirosyan should go to the body some, because he would land those body shots a little bit, slow him down some, then he could land up top.
Tried just then, and Lara picked it off.
Beautiful defense by Lara right there. You gotta love it.
It's like he saw it coming, Roy, and started to move with it.
And blocked it with both hands, the right and the left, like that. You can't let a man keep pitching the balls at you like that, because eventually one of them will hit you.
And Martirosyan has Lara moving in the direction he wants there, clockwise.
Yeah. You know, one of the things about the fighters from Cuba is that they have such extended amateur backgrounds that sometimes they don't fare well over a distance fight. Maybe that's what Martirosyan is trying to get him into.
Next Saturday night, World Championship Boxing has an exciting matchup for the lightweight title between Antonio DeMarco and Adrian Broner. Also top American heavyweight prospect, Seth Mitchell faces Jonathan Banks, who is also doubling as Vladimir Klitschko's new trainer. 1 week later, Andre Berto returns. The former welterweight champ faces Robert the Ghost Guerrero, who in his last fight looked strong and moving from lightweight to welterweight.
Right? Please, let's see if we get three and four in there, okay? All right? Threes and fours, they look great.
Can you see what I said? A fight was about to break out. Erislandy Lara missed with a straight left hand over the top. He grabbed him in a little headlock, a little MMA style, and he dropped a little pressure on him right there. He saw the arm flex. He had Martirosyan in retaliation, comes back with a little right hook to the body and said, hey, this guy's cheating. Now they both point at each other.
I like that from Martirosyan, Roy. He wasn't going to be bullied.
That's exactly right. You got to love that.
All right, let's check in with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
Okay, Bob, I got it 3-0, 30-27, vanished Martirosyan. I love the fact that this guy gets off first, jumps on him, keeps him backing up, lands that hard right hand, and he ain't letting Lara land that hard left hand. I mean, Lara's moving both sides, and vanished just jumps on him and whacks him with a hard right hand. And this has been going on for 3 rounds. Getting off first, landing the hardest shots.
No.
3-0, Martirosyan.
I wouldn't be surprised if judges had this fight all over the place, including the exact opposite score of Harold.
I wouldn't either, because I kind of don't agree with Harold in that one. Yeah. But I usually do agree with Harold, but I think it may be more like 2-1.
Well, I agree with you. I don't see Martirosyan pitching a shutout, but then again, we're calling the fight, and Harold is sitting here attentively scoring the fight.
That's exactly right, and he's one of the best I've ever seen at doing that.
Let's just say there's a lot of fights still to go.
As one fighter has picked up the intensity, the other fighter has matched it so far. Even though there's not excellent sustained action, the intensity continues to be ratcheted up.
You know what though, Max? I haven't seen anybody land a really good, clear headshot yet, except right there.
On cue.
Just as I was saying it.
Lara landed that left hand. Flicks a jab out. Boy, what could Lara be doing more of?
Well, he could be attacking the body more, but I think he's getting a little fatigued. I got to be honest with you. I think his body is starting to fatigue a little bit and to wear down a little bit. And I think Martirosyan went to the body right there, which is a smart thing. If Lara wants to win this fight, he has to continue to attack like he was doing earlier.
Is that a question in your mind, even though last year Lara withstood over 1,000 punches from Paul Williams and went 12 rounds?
Yeah, but see, against Paul Williams wasn't the best puncher. Martirosyan's a better puncher to me than Paul Williams.
Oh, low blow. That's a low blow.
That was low. You hit him low. That's okay.
So, Martirosyan.
I know it wasn't intentional, but don't do it.
Under the rules, has up to 5 minutes to regroup.
And he might take six.
I've never seen a fighter take the whole 5 minutes. There's too much pressure.
Hopkins once.
He may have taken
4 minutes
seven.
And 30 seconds.
He probably came closest. But there's a lot of pressure here. This from the crowd to, you know, get the event back underway.
You ready?
And there time you go. Martirosyan probably could have used some more time, but didn't take it.
Now he's taunting Lara a little bit. This fight definitely has an edge. And it started at the weigh-in yesterday.
No. Box.
Tell you what, the referee has his hands full here.
Yeah, I think right there, Jane 80 could have let them punch, because if you have one hand free, use it.
Box.
I think he's afraid of the dirty tactics that might take place.
Right. Keep control of the fight.
Exactly.
End of round four.
Look, you rocked him with the left hand already. I need more left hands going. You got to get busier, okay? Come on, you got to get busier, okay? I need you to get busier, okay? Look. Keep shooting that left hand, more left hands, okay? The left hands are there. All day long.
Close your eyes.
What?
I said he hit him more with the left hand.
Yeah. Let's keep going more with the left hand, okay?
Here's what I tell you, I think Lara may be showing a little fatigue. I thought usually the guy pushes his head down, but this seemed to be an intentional low blow. His head wasn't pushed.
That was a two-punch combination.
Exactly.
Left downstairs, head to the chin.
Exactly. So I don't think he really did it unintentionally. I think it may have been a planned shot.
Look that way.
So round number five begins. You heard Ronnie Shields in the corner of Lara say, you got to use that left hand more. Roy, it seems as if Lara has completely gotten away from that straight left hand of the bodies, he lands a nice combination to start round five.
Because of landing into the body, that's why you saw him be able to land it to the head right there. Because Martirosyan probably thought he was going to come to the body again and didn't back up, and Lara landed to the head. That was the advantage of him throwing that left body shot.
Scott! Scott!
Oh, on the brick again.
No, that was bad. Don't do that again.
Martirosyan's done that twice.
I don't blame him. I think he's taking Lara's dirty tactics, and I think Lara has been somewhat dirty here. And he's taking it as a sign of desperation from Lara.
Lara got caught with the right hand going straight back.
And he's not going to let Lara be the boss in there, so to speak.
That's the smartest thing he can do. And like I said, if you're in Vitus's corner, you got to think that as the fight goes on, it tilts in his favor.
Vitus has fought very well so far, particularly considering the gap in world-class experience on the professional level between these two, and the fact that Lara was a pretty substantial favorite going into this fight.
At 4-1 here at the win.
The thing I think that hurts Lara Max is the thing that you said about him before he fought Paul Williams, which is he's not really a busy guy. He tries to be almost too economical with his punches. He doesn't want to land, throw a shot unless he almost knows he's going to land.
Yeah, and it seems to be here he's relying on his defense to set up pot shot opportunities for him and counter punch opportunities for him, hoping to hurt Martirosyan with something.
And I think that's why Harold has given Martirosyan every round. Now right here, Martirosyan must put the pressure on Lara. He can't allow Lara to take his time to fight at his own pace. Lara can do this all night long.
And Martirosyan's not a guy who does any one thing particularly well, but he's a nice, well-rounded fighter and a tough kid.
See, right there, he should have went to the body, then back up to the head first.
He's going to have to outwork Lara here.
Exactly. You're not going to hit the Cuban as experienced as he is with no one shot, just throwing one shot at a time.
Left hand inside from Lara. Martirosyan tries to chop in with a right. Number five. Well, you know, this fight, very subtle in these rounds, tough rounds to score. We're going to give you a look at sort of the point of view of what the judges are looking at. And Dave Moretti, one of the three judges that's scoring this fight, he had a camera right over his shoulder. And he's looking between the ring ropes, but you see, you know, the referees in the way, actions taking place on the far side of the ring. Harold, how do you negotiate some of these things?
Well, you know, I'm watching Vanish Martirosyan with that aggressive right hand. I think it's a, Dave Moretti's got a good view of the fight, that's for sure. The referee's not blocking him. The fighter's not blocking him. He should.
Well, the point, Harold, was that the judges have different points of view from different sides of the ring, and sometimes you get varied scorecards, I guess.
Yeah, well, that's why you got three judges on three different sides.
Tell him, Harold.
As Harold was writing down his score, he missed the part where the ref was blocking Moretti's view.
So we begin round number six, scheduled for 12.
Watch your feet. Your buckles.
Very rare you see two angry guys go 12 rounds. I think these guys are too angry to really last 12 rounds. I mean, they may, but with all the anger involved, something's bound to happen soon.
Also, with a southpaw versus the right-handed fighter, and we've already seen a couple clashes of heads, maybe at least one intentional from Lara. Martirosyan's cut in the past over that left eye, and that's also a danger for him.
It's happened on three different occasions to Martirosyan.
You see low blows, late blows.
Hitting on the clinch. Headlocks.
A lot of anger up here. See right there, Martirosyan, this is what gets me about him. He has to unload to the body when he does get a chance. Can't hit a guy with that much experience with one headshot at a time. And Erislandy has to realize that the judges are not going to judge in his favor by him throwing one shot at a time either.
I think Martirosyan thinks he's in position to land because he has left foot outside of Lara's right foot. But when he comes in, or when Lara comes in, Lara quickly changes that and gets position on Martirosyan with his feet.
And that's that experience factor, Max.
Right, Martirosyan thinks he's in position to land, but by the time it comes, he's not.
And
just
plus,
like there.
And plus, he's only throwing one shot there. If he threw three or four, maybe he could land before the kid moves out the way, before Lara moves.
You know, and what Martirosyan just came wildly winging in, and you saw Lara sidestep it. I mean, that's cut right out of the amateur game.
Exactly. Good hook by Martirosyan. But he threw three punches that time, and the third one landed. Tell you what, Lara's breathing very hard, Max.
Yeah, Lara's doing a lot of things, I think, that coming into the fight, he might have supposed would be enough to control Martirosyan. And in certain respects, he has. Right there, a really good straight left. But is he winning these rounds doing this? Is he doing enough to carry these rounds?
I think some of them he is.
Some of them, yes, but enough of them.
Like in the last round, I mean, he started off the round a couple combinations. End of round number six.
Better round, okay? That was a better round. That was a lot better round. Okay, now listen, I still. Let him run into the jab, but then shoot the left hand right away. Let him spin, let him spin. Okay? Give him a deal.
You're pressing him and he's running like that. He can't win those rounds, son, okay?
Okay.
Right, keep pressing, make him run, okay? Keep letting him run, okay? All right, now we need to hit the right hand and the left hook from the end. Put more together. Put three together for me, okay?
Here you see Lara come in.
You heard Freddie Roach say to Martirosyan, put three together. Roy, the one time in that round he put three together, the third one landed, that left hand.
That's exactly right. That's why I said if he puts punches together, he may land the second, third, or fourth
Stop.
Punch. But throwing one at a time, he's never going to kiss Lara.
Box.
Let's check in with Harold Letterman.
Okay, Bob. I've got it 4 rounds to two. 58, 56. Vanish Martirosyan. I just think he's too aggressive. Erislandy Lara not landing that left hand enough. I mean, he circles. He flips out that right hand, which is probably illegal because he backhands it.
Lara is cut over his left or by his left eye, it looks like.
And that was a right hand that Martirosyan landed. That was the best punch that I've seen him land to the head all night.
Harold, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I just want to say I've got a 4-2 Martirosyan because I like his aggressiveness and I like the fact that he's getting up first and landing that hard right hand. 4-2 Vanish Martirosyan.
Martirosyan's obviously doing something right because against Paul Williams, we saw Lara able to fly his head constantly during the course of a round. Here, once or twice around, you notice that Martirosyan's head snaps back from a shot, but it's not nearly as consistent. Well, there it was. Not nearly as consistent as in the Williams fight.
Yeah, there's concern on the face of Lara as he was pawing at that left eye where there appears to be a cut.
Well, the difference is Martirosyan is a much better puncher as far as power-wise than Paul Williams. So Lara can't do the things he did against Williams and not be afraid of getting hit. He has to worry about getting hit by the big shot from Martirosyan. That he didn't have to worry about against Paul Williams. As you know, Paul Williams is a cumulative puncher. He throws 1,000 punches a fight. So none of them are really spectacularly hard. He just throws a lot of them.
First time that Lara has been cut in his career.
Lara is starting to find the range against Williams. It was the overhand left, and he picked that up from Sergio Martinez watching that fight against Williams. And here, the straight left hand seems to be having increasing success this round from Lara.
Martirosyan is seeming to be a little tired himself. Oh, good shot.
Scott, you turn your head and you help.
Oh, another good left hand.
Really found the range with that left hand this round.
With the counter left mainly. And what he's doing is allowing Martirosyan to come right down the middle. He's taking one step back off of the attack, and then he's throwing his own left hand.
Yeah, in the earlier rounds, it was maybe two or three of those that landed cleanly in a round, and here there's been half a dozen.
Martirosyan brings that right hand. Lara steps in with his left.
And if Martirosyan keeps backing straight back, he's going to consistently eat that left hand.
End of round seven. Good counter left hand by Lara.
They're going to have to make an adjustment in Martirosyan's corner. Because right now, Lara can't miss with it. Freddie Roach is a five-time trainer of the year.
Wife Judy looking on. Her husband cut.
Okay, go to water. I got it.
Hey,
I see that's the best kind of rounds we need, okay? Get that out of his eye. There you go. Okay? Look, listen. You got to keep picking it up like that, okay? Keep shooting that left hand in. I need more punches this round. Now we're coming down to the real rounds now, okay? Okay? Let's pick it up now. You won that round, okay? You keep working like that, okay?
Here you see Martirosyan step off the right hand and counter with the short overhand right, which caused a cut on Lara, I believe. But later in the round, you see Lara step off of the hook and right hand and come back with a 1-2 of his own from the southpaw position. Great left hand right on the chin. And Martirosyan took it well.
And I did receive confirmation from referee Jay Nadian between rounds that that cut on the left eye of Lara was as the result of that punch that we showed. So if for any reason that cut worsened during the course of this fight and Lara could not continue, it would be a win for Martirosyan as opposed to an accidental clash of heads in which they'd have to go to the scorecards.
Oh, Martirosyan just hurt him bad with a left hook, I think.
Let go. Step back.
Good left hook by Martirosyan.
And he avoided the left hand from Lara there. What did he do there, Roy, to avoid that left hand that time?
I think he threw the hook and went either to the left or to the right. He didn't stay straight up or back straight back.
He needs to keep doing that.
Yeah, but he's thinking too much. You see how he's waiting right there? That's getting him hit because he stands right there and he's just a steel target. You cannot be a steel target and bang straight back like that.
And then he went straight back again and another left hand. Got it.
We'll run right into the left hand every time, just like that. See that?
Two more.
Every time. Cannot bang straight back from a southpaw.
The old saying is class tells over time. The longer a fight goes, the more it favors the more skillful, experienced fighter. Martirosyan's going to have to either ratchet up the offense or figure out a way to avoid that straight left or both.
Well, that left hand to the body, I think, has worn him down some as well. So I think he's just as tired, if not tired, than Lara is.
Again, Lara trying to set up that straight left hand.
As long as Lara is allowed to attack first, which is what they mean when they say be first, then Martirosyan is never going to catch him. Like that. As long as he can mount his attack like that first, he's always going to have the advantage.
Thank you. Box.
Lara's throwing almost twice as many jabs as he has power shots in this fight.
No. Stand up. Look.
And I think Jay Nady is doing a very good job in this fight. Keeping it as clean as he can keep it, because these two guys don't intend to stay clean.
Agreed.
Let him go. Thank you.
Work our way to the end of round of eight. The schedule for 12. There's that left hand again from Lara that finds the mark. Well, we showed you the boxing calendar and some great fights to finish out 2012, including next week's World Championship Boxing. On November 17 in Atlantic City, 130-pound star Adrian Broner makes his world championship boxing debut. Looking to continue a string of impressive performances as he moves up to a new weight class.
Brutal body shots. Escobedo trying to hang on, getting hammered against the rope. And Joel Diaz is holding up a towel. He's seen enough. Adrian Broner's got to have a TKO victory.
His opponent is lightweight title holder Antonio DeMarco. The rugged Mexican slugger turned heads with a gutsy knockout victory over Jorge Linares last year and is riding high after stopping John Molina in less than a minute on September 8th. That's Antonio DeMarco versus Adrian Broner live on World Championship Boxing November 17th from Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. Also that night, American heavyweight prospect Seth Mitchell takes on Jonathan Banks.
And we begin round number 9 of this scheduled 12-rounder. Erislandy Lara, Vanish Martirosyan. No knockdowns to this point in the fight. Lara cut left eye from a punch in round 7.
Oh, stop!
And the heads come together again.
And there's blood really coming out of that left eye over the left eye of Martirosyan.
Let's go to the doctor.
Yeah, they're going to stop
bad
this
one. Cut.
Yeah, they're going to stop this one. That's
this
a wrap.
This is the fourth time that left eye has been cut.
This is a wrap. They're going to have to stop this one. Trust me.
I can't see.
Yeah, they're going to stop this one. I told you something was going to happen.
And you hear Martirosyan saying, I can't see at all.
Yeah.
I mean, that is a terrible cut. And you heard Jay Nady telling the judges, you have to score the round, despite
the
fact that only 26 seconds elapsed. Brutal cut on the left eye of Vanish Martirosyan.
But Martirosyan still can win this decision because it will go to the scorecards.
Harold, how do you score a round that went for 26 seconds?
It ain't easy, let me tell you.
I mean, is this where an even round is acceptable?
An even round could be acceptable. I thought Erislandy Lara landed a few punches earlier in round. But, you know, it may be the difference in a fight, Bob. Let's face reality. The rules are you got to score the partial rounds when a fight is stopped due to an accidental headbutt.
All right, so I'll take out the copy box numbers here from this 26 seconds. Lara landed 1 of 6. Roy, here's where they just came together.
Yeah, they were both coming to throw power punches. The good thing for Lara was that his head, his chin was tucked. And as you saw, Martirosyan's chin wasn't tucked quite as low, so he got the worst of the headbutt. Once again, you see both coming in. Lara's head is low. You see the top of his head hit the eye part of Martirosyan.
Lara knew there was going to be a clash of heads. He wisely lowered his head and turned his face away.
Well, he didn't know that it was. He knew that it may be a clash of heads.
Right, he was protecting himself.
Exactly.
From the same thing that happened to Martirosyan. Now, copy box had 1 of 6 connects for Lara in the round, and Martirosyan was 0 for 2, according to copy box. Remember, Jane 80 instructing the judges at ringside, you need to score the round despite the fact that only 26 seconds elapsed. It's an accidental clash of heads, so they got to go to the judges' cards.
Smells like a rematch.
But you know, if you had this thing 4 apiece and you had to score that last round, that could be the difference in who wins and loses.
Unless you score the last round even, then you got a draw.
It pays to throw punches.
And you heard Martirosyan when the ringside physician came over to look at it. But fans, who do you think won? Text M for Martirosyan, L for Lara, 53548. Folks, when you come up with that decision, before you send that text, make sure you judge that last round, all 26 seconds of it.
Yeah, we got you.
So is Lara victorious? Does Martirosyan suffer the first loss of his career? Well, the judges' scorecards. Harold Letterman, let's take a look at who the judges are. Harold, let's take a look at the judges and a little scouting report.
Yeah, I was waiting for it to come up. Okay, Dave Moretti, in my mind, the outstanding judge in the world. I mean, this guy's very good. He's the one that had Sugar Ray Leonard 7-5 over Marvin Hagler. I love him for that decision.
Ricardo Ocasio, one of the new guys, been judging since 2007, did a very, very good job in Juan Carlos Burgos over Luis Cruz. It was a majority decision. Ocasio had it right 7-3 for Juan Carlos Burgos. Jerry Roth, definitely the veteran guy. The only knock on Jerry Roth is 115, 113 in the Pacquiao Timothy Bradley, but at least he had the right winner. He didn't have it big enough. I've got it 86-85. Five rounds to four, Erislandy Lara. Very, very close fight either way.
All right, let's find out how the judges had it scored. Here's Lupe Contreras.
Ladies and gentlemen, after an accidental clash of heads at the 26-second mark of round number 9, referee Jay Nitti calls a halt to the action in accordance with Nevada rules. We consult the official scorecard to determine a winner. Jerry Roth scores it 86-85 in favor of Martirosyan. Ricardo Ocasio, 87-84 in favor of Lara. And Judge Dave Moretti scores the bout 86-86. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is declared a technical decision draw.
And Dave Moretti is the only one of the three judges that scored that partial round even. He had the final round, that 26-second ninth round, 10-10, thus 86-86. Meanwhile, Richard Ocasio had the round 10-9 in favor of Lara, and Judge Jerry Roth had the last round 10-9 in favor of Lara, although Roth's scorecard still went with Martirosyan. But Dave Moretti, Dave Moretti scored that last round for either one, then that boxer would have won by way of split decision. So Moretti's 10-10, 26-second ninth round is the reason why we have a technical decision draw. Let's take a look at the final CompuBox numbers for Martirosyan and Lara. Neither guy was very busy. Lara threw 31 punches per round. Martirosyan threw 30. Lara landed at a higher percentage. Power punches in the fight, 40 of 95 for Lara. Lara threw 11 power punches per round. Martirosyan threw 20 power punches per round. He landed at 16%. Max Kellerman is standing by in the ring. He'll talk to both boxers. Max?
Okay, and a draw. It doesn't really matter where we start, but Vanas, I'll start with you. What do you think about the official verdict draw?
I mean, it was a close fight. It was a close fight, but he ran all night. You know, it's not the amateurs, it's the professionals. He was running all night.
You seem to be having some success early. As the fight wore on, he seemed to keep nailing you with that left hand. What did Freddie tell you in the corner to avoid getting hit with that punch?
I mean, Freddie was telling me to keep pressing the action, you know, keep pushing pressure on him. You know, he was running all night. It was tough to catch him, you know. I mean, he's good from the amateurs, you know, getting points and running. That's all he was doing.
A couple of times, tried some rough stuff with you in the clinches, and you responded both times by whacking him with a right hand to the body. Tell me about that.
I mean, you know, he's kind of a dirty fighter, you know. He got me a low blow, the head, but he keeps coming in with his head. I mean, he's good with stuff like that.
Vanas, meanwhile, you've been criticized in your pro career for not fighting a top fighter. Here tonight, you stepped up and fought one of the best junior middleweights in the world. How do you feel about your performance?
I feel great. You know, it sucks for the bad ahead, but, you know, our plan was to come on later on because he gets tired. That's what we see. So, you know, the last round, I kind of took off and we wanted to finish strong, but unfortunately, the headbutt happened.
Rematch, what's next for you?
100%. As soon as the stitches come out, I want a rematch. 100%. Do it again.
Thanks, Vanas. Erislandy, your thoughts on the official verdict?
Bueno, Vanas es un buen peleador, okay? Le di golpe como me dio la gana. Eso fue un accidente, se dio un cabezazo. Lo que yo creo que no tiene corazón. Es un pendejo, no tiene corazón.
You know, Vanas is a good fighter, but I hit him with everything. I hit him with everything that I wanted to. And, you know, that was a headbutt. It happens in fights.
He said you're a dirty fighter. You did appear to use some rough tactics in the clinches a couple times with some headlocks. What do you think about his comment?
Él dice que soy un peleador sucio. Nunca en mi vida me han quitado un punto por un golpe sucio ni nada que he hecho mal. Soy un excelente peleador, soy mejor peleador que él y lo he mostrado aquí y lo muestro aquí donde quiera.
He said I'm a bad. He said I'm not a good fighter. He said I low blows and fouls and all that stuff. But they never taken a point away from me in my life, in my entire life. And I show that here, and I show that in my professional career, and I'll show it tonight and anywhere else.
So, in official verdicts so far, you still don't have an actual win against a top junior middleweight, even though most people feel like you've won those fights against top junior middleweights. I suspect most people will feel you probably won this fight too tonight. Why are you unable to get the official decision in big fights?
No sé, oficialmente, recuerden que esta es una cartelera de top rank, esta es una cartelera de Golden Boy, cartelera de top rank, y él es boxeador de top rank. Yo oficialmente iba en esta pelea.
Remember that this is a top rank Golden Boy card, you know, and he's one of their fighters. But I officially won this bout.
He tenido la mala suerte que las dos veces que he peleado fuera de mi promoción, siempre pasa algo. Si no me roban la pelea, la dan empate.
The bad thing, the bad luck that I've had in all those fights, it hasn't been my promotion. It's been a draw, or they say that I've lost.
He said he'd like a rematch. Would you like a rematch?
Estoy 100%. Quiero, si quiere, ahora mismo seguimos la pelea. Estoy ready, que llegaban los últimos rounds, y estaba seguro que lo iban a quedar. Estaba subiendo el nivel y estaba bajando.
Yes, 100%. You know, and if we continue the fight, we could continue it right now. But absolutely, in the final few rounds, I was going up and he was going down.
Thank you, Erislandy. Tough luck fighter. I haven't seen you lose yet, but you can't get the wins, Bob.